after a hotly contested start to the series. What's in store for us here? It's game two of the NLDS between the Miami Marlins and the St. Louis Cardinals. Hi again, everyone. Matt Vaskirjian. Welcome to our special postseason coverage of baseball on the show. I'm joined by Eric Karros and Steve Lyons. And Steve, an important ballgame coming up here in game two.
Yeah, and remember that this is just a five-game series, so getting that first win under your belts is especially important right here. If they can get a second win now, they could really give themselves a good chance to move on.
Set for what should be a good one. Lineups and first pitch are next. The crowd is ready to erupt as their guys get set to take the field. Let's join public address announcer Mike Carlucci.
And now your 2016 St. Louis Cardinals.
And briefly here, a glance at the two starters who'll get the ball here in this one. And here's how the visiting Miami Marlins will line up in this one. Steve, what's the key for them here tonight?
Well, they're facing a guy today that throws a lot of strikes, so you're going to have to be aggressive early in the count, but get the ball up in the zone. Shorten up a little bit, put the ball in play.
Carlos Martinez is on the mound for game two. What do we need to know here, EK?
Well, guys, he's got a career ERA of just under 3.5. He's thrown some great ball games in his career. He's thrown some real clunkers. Hopefully, for his sake, he throws well in this one.
And with that, a look at the defense for the St. Louis Cardinals. It's brought to us by Majestic. Any thoughts, Eric?
Well, guys, Matt Carpenter can play a number of positions. He played second, third base. For me, he's better suited at third base. Very sure-handed. He's got a good enough arm to play over there. And I think he's a bit more comfortable at that position.
D. Gordon heads for the batter's box, and we are just about ready for some evening baseball. Now the first pitch of the night is looked at for ball one as we get underway right at 7:05 on the nose.
First pitch, 7:05.
And back-to-back pitches out of the zone to begin the evening. It's 2-0 now. Not the warmest night you'll see around here, and even 50 degrees at game time. Late swing on the hitter's count. Still a good count for him now, however, at 2-1. And that's in there above the belt, so it's even now, 2-2.
A little conviction behind that fastball.
And the fastball misses high and away there. It's full, 3-2. Waiting next, there's Christian Yelich. Checked his swing there, and did he go? No, he did not, says the third base umpire, so it's ball four.
In the second spot tonight.
Well, let's see it again in show motion.
Yelich.
I don't know. That's awfully close. And he might have got away with one there.
Christian Yelich will stand in, coming off a great performance in the game one victory.
And he really is the X factor in this lineup. And if he can stay hot, they're going to have a good chance of pulling this thing out.
First offering on its way. Breaking ball for a strike, 0-1.
Well, you know, you hear it all the time because it's true. First pitch strikes are so important. It really changes the complexion of the at-bat for not only the pitcher, but the hitter as well, especially when you've got a good hitter up there.
Now the 0-1. And he'll look at a fastball just off the black, and it's even at 1. Looks like he employed the slide step on that last pitch.
Well, maybe you see a little cat and mouse game going between the pitcher and the runner right now. We'll see who wins this duel.
And he comes back with a fastball, 1-2 now. So let's take a peek at the umpiring crew in this one. Behind the plate is Matthew Ross.
Well, Matt, with Ross behind the plate, hitters know they need to expand the strike zone a little bit. He likes to ring it up when it's on the black or even a little off of it.
Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. Curveball got him swinging for the first down.
Well, this curveball, it just disappears. He thinks he's right on it at the plate. Look where it winds up, completely out of the zone. And that's what you want as a pitcher. You want hitters to chase pitches that aren't strikes.
Throw over to the bag and the runner back. Here's John Jason now. Runner goes for second. Pitch is a called strike. The throw. It skips in and he's safe. Close play, but he's in there.
If you're a stolen base kind of guy, most of your stolen bases are on the pitcher, not the catcher. But this was a slide step that he used right here, and he still stole the base. I think you got to blame the catcher for this one.
Runner goes for third. Not nearly in time as he takes third easily.
Normally, when you see a guy steal third base, it's because he got a nice walking lead, really got out there nice and far. But here, he had almost no lead whatsoever when he made his break. Very fortunate to get away with that one.
Has to be thinking strikeout here. And a good curveball there, but he wouldn't bite. It's 1-2.
I tell you, that was not an easy take.
It sure wasn't, especially when you've got to protect on an 0-2 count.
In the dirt and block behind the plate. Throw to the plate, and the recovery will be in time to get him at the plate. And that's going to hurt because now there are two away. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. And now a curveball as he's got to lean out of the way. That one nearly got him.
And we'll see him work both sides of the plate with the curveball going forward. Or maybe not that far in, but he'll move that pitch around.
Lifted in the air to shallow center field. Grichuk is there. He makes the play, and that'll end the inning. Nothing doing for the Marlins. And now the Cardinals get their first shot at it here. No score. Now a moment here in St. Louis to look at the Cardinals' starting lineup. What's the key to sending fans home smiling tonight, Steve?
I'll tell you what. This team has their ace on the mound, so it's probably not going to take a whole lot of offense to get a win for them.
Wei-Yin Chen will be on the bump for game two of the series. What do you have for us on him, EK?
Well, guys, remember, he's got five pitches to work with, so that really makes it difficult for the hitter. He can change speeds, ball moving in and out. Not a lot of fun for the hitters.
And with a quick breather here, let's give you a look at the Miami D. It's brought to us by Majestic. Eric, what do we need to know?
Well, guys, this defense is rock solid up the middle. They've got a gold glover at second base who is athletic, agile, and has range second to none.
Steven Piscotty comes to the plate to lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
Leading off for the Cardinals, right fielder Steven Piscotty.
Now Now a swing and a miss as they start him out on a pitch well inside for strike one. And low, it's a ball and a strike. Fastball not close, and he runs it to two balls and a strike. Chen's got his target. Here it is on 2-1. Line drive to left, but he'll hardly need to move out there in left as this is hauled in for the first out.
The minute he hits that, he's thinking it's a base hit all the way, but it's one of those situations where you get penalized for hitting the ball too hard. And this stayed up long enough to find the outfielder's glove out there.
Here's Randall Grichuk. Now a check swing here and a little looper. Echevarria is there for it, two gone. And so with two away now, let's give you another look at our playoff bracket as you see what could lie ahead for the winner in this series. Matt Holliday gets his first cuts now. The bases are empty, and there are two away here in the opening frame.
Yeah, nothing doing so far here. He kind of needs to put up a tough at-bat right here just to make this guy work a little bit.
And here's a called strike to the 36-year-old veteran. It's nothing and one.
Yeah, the best way to neutralize this guy's power, just keep putting pitches right there.
Fastball, and he's quickly in the hole, 0-2.
And you kind of get the sense that he's not really messing around out there too much. There hasn't been a whole lot of setting guys up here in this inning. He's just trying to get himself back into that dugout as fast as he can.
It swung on and hit in the air. Stanton on the run. He can't get there, so the inning will continue. And he is in the scoring position at second with their first hit, a two-out double.
Well, it's never too late to get a first inning rally started. This one's going to find the gap for two bases. So now it needs to give your cleanup guy a shot to maybe drive in that first run of the game.
Here's Matt Carpenter. This will take a look at a slider here that finds the zone for strike one.
All of a sudden, you got to be careful now with the cleanup guy up there with a runner in scoring position. He could be in danger of giving up that first run after all.
Runner in scoring position at second with two down. And he misses with it, 1-1.
Well, that's a good thing that pitch was above the strike zone, because a few inches lower, that ball's right in his wheelhouse.
Good take there, and it's 2-1 now to the St. Louis third baseman. Rounded down the third baseline, but this will be a foul ball as that evens things at 2-2. The 2-2 pitch. This one misses, and that'll fill the count here, 3-2 with two away.
And he does have a base open, so he doesn't have to give in on 3-2.
Still hanging with him, another good swing to keep it going. Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. Danger averted following the two-out double. Game 2 coverage rolls on after this. Giancarlo Stanton makes his way to the plate. He'll get us started here in the top of the second.
And this is a guy that can make a big change in this game with one swing of the bat, because you know he has big time power.
And a high strike there, 0-1.
And you know, I think it's going to be important that when guys get their pitches, they take advantage. There it looked like he was taken all the way, and he may not get another pitch that catches that much of the plate.
And he watches a called strike at the knees. No balls and two strikes.
So tough to hang in there on that pitch. But you got to do it. You can't give up on that inside corner, or this guy will bury you.
Now a swing and a miss, and Stanton is down on strikes for round number one.
Boy, he just dominated that at-bat right there. You want to see a power pitcher go right through a guy? This is a three-pitch see you later right here. Have a seat.
In is the catcher, Jonathan Lucroy, as he will take strike one on the fastball here. No balls and a strike.
The fastball looks awfully sharp here early on. Sound sharp, too.
Right over the top with that curveball, and it's 0-2.
He's found a pretty nice rhythm out here early on.
No score here as we play inning number two. Fastball, strike three called, as he couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away.
Well, it doesn't seem like it's taken him too long to get into his groove. He's now struck out three of the first five guys he's faced. I'd say that he's looking pretty strong early on.
Here's Marcelo Zuna. Pulls this one in the air out to left. Holiday is under it, and the inning is over. So they go quietly here in this half inning. On now to the bottom of the second, and we are tied 0-0. Johnny Peralta strides into the box now to lead off the home half of the second inning.
The shortstop, Johnny Peralta.
Chen's ready. First pitch on the way. Starts him out with a slider for a strike.
Yeah, and even though that's a tough one to get on top of, I think he'd say he got away with one right there. That's in too good a location when the matchup's not in your favor.
It's sharply toward third, and a base hit, so the leadoff man is on to begin the inning.
As we look at that again, you know, this is not a bad pitch by any stretch. If he throws this pitch 10 times, I bet he gets him out 9 of them. But here you just have to tip your cap to the guy at the plate.
Stepping in, Brandon Moss. He'll get to take his first cuts here. In there, strike one.
And you know, this is a guy that loves the ball down and in. It's one of the locations he really covers well, so they're going to want to mix their spots here.
Fastball called for strike two.
Yeah, and it doesn't look like he's trying to get a ground ball here. He's coming right after him, trying to get a punch out.
And he missed with it. It's 1-2.
And I think that might have been a little bit of a purpose pitch right there up in the zone. Now I think he's going to come back down with something to try to get that strikeout.
Now Now the fastball is right by him as he swings and misses for the first out of the inning.
Well, you never know. This might have been the lesser of two evils right here. If you take this pitch, you know it's strike three. If you swing, you might bounce into a double play ball. So the best he could have done was maybe fouled that thing off, but instead, he comes up empty.
Here's Jed Jerko now, as he'll take a look at a slider that can't make it back to the corner. It's ball one. Belted high in the air out to left. Back goes Ozuna. He makes the play. Really had to hustle to get to that one. Two gone now. Yadier Molina set to take his first cuts with a man at first and two away.
Yeah, and he's going to have to find a gap to give that man on first a chance to score.
Here's the first pitch to him. A fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0.
Yeah, looked like he hit the target. That's a tough pitch to lay off, but he made it pan out.
The 1-0 delivery. Nope. And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0. Three and oh now. You figure he's taken now on the three ball count.
Maybe even taken two.
Bottom of the second here with no score. And he gets this fastball over back to 3-1 now.
Yeah, a much better pitch there than the one he threw on 2-0.
And a good at-bat that time as he lays off for ball four. And as a result, that'll move a runner up into scoring position now with two away.
Well, at the very least, this is going to allow the pitcher to hit here in this inning now instead of having to lead off the next inning.
Carlos Martinez gets a shot now with deuces all around. Two on, two out here in inning number two. He's set. Here it comes. And he lays off there 1-0.
Yeah, he didn't seem to do him any favors with the previous batter, and now here's another call that goes against him on the mound.
This one's a strike. It's 1-1. This one's blooped out toward right center field. Stanton shading to his right. And that ends the inning. Cards strand a couple. He'll move to the third with no score. Derek Dietrich leads it off here. Bottom third of the order set to go here in the third.
Well, he's faced the minimum so far, and obviously it's still early, but they need to get something going because you can't let this guy settle in out there.
Into the windup and the pitch. And here's a first pitch curveball that bounces on him there. It's ball one. And, ooh, looked like a definite pitcher's pitch there on the inside, 1-1.
Real good lateral movement on that two-seam fastball. That pitch is money for him when it's moving like that. So just keep on throwing it.
No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
He wanted to go after that one, but that's a good eye to just watch it all the way in.
That's going to even up the count at 2-2. Ball three. 3-2 now. You have to figure that he's really going to need to keep the walks in check if he's going to have success here.
I was thinking the same thing. No free rides. You got to make these guys earn it.
Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. And he takes strike three called on the fastball. One gone.
And this is where the scouting report really pays off. I mean, sometimes you just got to go looking for a soft spot in the guy's zone, and they found one there.
Here's Echevarria now. Yes, he'll take a look at ball one. That's wide, 2-0. Outside, 3-0 now.
And this is just a guy that's going to be happy to take a walk, so I'm a little bit surprised that they haven't challenged him a little bit more from the mound.
And there's a strike as he'll try to work his way back. It's 3-1. And this misses for ball four. The second walk he surrendered here in the first three innings.
Still no hits on the ledger, but at least they get themselves a base runner here. And that's a step in the right direction.
The pitcher, Wei-Yin Chen, steps up to the plate in a sacrifice situation. So let's see if that is indeed on right here.
Textbook sack situation here, guys.
Off-speed pitch, and this one runs in and nearly gets him here.
Sometimes if you let that changeup go too soon, it'll take off on you. He's lucky that didn't hit him.
Marlins are still on the lookout for their first hit of the ball game. And they'll try to stay out of the double play here as he lays this one down. And good hustle to get over and tag him for the out.
Well, this is a nice job here of divvying himself up. You see him square and put this ball down over toward the right side of the infield, and that's just where you want it to be. They do put the tag on him, but hey, he gets the job done.
Here's D. Gordon now as he looks at a fastball that's in there for strike one. Here's one that misses high. It's 1-1. Way outside, nearly to the backstop, 2-1. Third inning, no score to this point. Now a sharply hit ball back up the middle. And that's in there, base hit. Around third and being waved on home. And they're going to take a 1-0 lead as the run comes across to score.
A really good at bat here as we watch it again. Look, he finds his pitch, drives it right back up the middle, and with two away, that runner doesn't have to hold up and make sure it drops. He's moving on contact, and he's going to wind up scoring easily.
In is Christian Yelich, and a pitch out, nothing doing though, and that's ball one. Runners off for second. A pitch out. The throw. And they'll nail him at second on a brilliant call to pitch out. And the inning is over. So it's one run on one hit. No errors. And no one left on base. We'll head now to the home half of inning number three. It's the Marlins 1 and the Cardinals nothing. Stephen Piscotty. Digs into the box in the bottom of inning number three.
And guys, this is the guy you want leading off this inning. He's your leadoff man, so maybe he can get things started, set the table for a little bit of a rally.
High and deep to left center field. Yelich going back, still going back. But he has no chance to make the play. It's off the wall. And he'll get in there standing up with a leadoff double.
Well, that didn't take long to get a man into scoring position. And quite truthfully, it's probably a little bit unlucky that he's not touching third and home here as well. No waiting for a pitch here. He jumps on that very first pitch of the inning and nearly drives it out of here.
Rendell Grichuk will get an opportunity now following the leadoff double.
And with his guys down by a run, at the very least, you need to try to shoot something to the right side. Hopefully get that runner over to third with one out.
Here's a slider to start things out, looked at for ball one.
Well, obviously, you want a base hit here and hopefully tie this game. But a ground ball to the right side, that wouldn't be so bad either.
No one out with a runner at second. And look out as that fastball ran in and got him. Ouch, bang.
And I don't think this partisan crowd is going to like that too much. One thing you don't want to do as an opposing pitcher, or two things actually. One, you don't want to get the crowd involved early, and two, you don't want to set yourself up for a possible big inning. Now, both of those things have come true.
Matt Holliday standing in now as he'll take a look at a high strike that time. It's nothing and one.
Very important here with two guys on following the hit by pitch. He had to come out and establish the count in his favor, and he did just that.
First and second here with nobody out. And he falls behind 0-2. They really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out.
You want to talk about throwing a fastball in a guy's kitchen? He came in, sat down, had a cup of coffee with him. You aren't going to tie a guy up any better than that.
Here's Matt Carpenter. As he'll take a tough pitch on the outside part of the plate for strike one. Tap fouled at home plate. Runners are at first and second with one away. Oh, and this is swung on and missed. Four strikeouts already, and that's out number two.
And that changeup's not really a pitch you can sit on with two strikes. Because if he gives you that fastball, you'll be an hour late on it. That's a great job of not showing that pitch until he was ready to punch him out.
Here's Johnny Peralta now as he swings and hits this one foul off to the right and out of play. Two down, runners at first and second. Hit hard on the ground towards second. Gordon is there.
Just an airmail shot that time. The pickup's good, but this ball just sails straight over his head at first base. Good effort to try and go up and get it, but this is well out of his reach.
Here's the first baseman, Brandon Moss. as the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one.
Yeah, you know, when a pitcher gets into a little bit of a jam out there, you can bet he's going with his best stuff. So we may see a heavy dose of that slider right now.
Bases are loaded here, two down. That's in there, and he's deep in the hole now, 0-2.
He's still got to make one more big pitch, but this is a great start with the bases loaded.
Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. A golden opportunity to get on the board here goes for naught. Back with more postseason baseball in game two after this. Christian Yelich is ready here as we begin the top of the fourth.
Center fielder, Christian Yelich.
He's ready. Here's the first offering. Now a breaking ball runs in on him as he's got to get his hands out of the way on that pitch. Oh, much too tardy on the fastball. 1-1.
He might have thought he'd be getting another dose of that curveball because he was way behind that one.
Hit in the air to left field. After it is Holiday. He gets to it and makes the catch for the first down. Into the box, John Jaso. He flew out in his last at bat. First delivery to him on the way. Behind on that one, now behind in the count, 0-1. Off the plate, one ball, one strike. Taken high and deep to right. Piscotty ranging back. At the track. Now a leaping effort at the wall, but he comes up empty. This one is gone. Home run. A solo shot here to straightaway right field. His second home run of the series, and the Marlins have taken a 2-0 lead.
Well, this is the chance you take when you work up in the zone like this. I mean, this is right in his happy zone, and he jumps all over it and sends it right over the wall.
Up next for the
Giancarlo Marlins. Stanton now.
Right fielder, Giancarlo Stanton.
Now a curveball that misses here to the cleanup man. It's 1-0. Got him out on his front foot there as it swung on and missed for strike one. Hot shot to third. And a sliding try there at third, but it skips by him, a base hit.
The perils of being a third baseman. I remember it well. He's way out in front of this pitch and just hammers it towards the hole. And you can see by the reaction at third, the coaches are telling you, hey, get in front of that one. Yeah, right. You get in front of that one.
In is the catcher, Jonathan Lucroy. And there he goes towards second. Into the seats, 0-1. And he's really getting the better of him now. It's strike two.
And this is what he needs out there right now. He has to find some confidence in those secondary pitches, and that's a good change up there.
Here's the 0-2. lays off that time, and it's 1-2.
Well, that two-seam fastball ran a little too much off the plate, but now that sets him up to work with something away and maybe even an off-speed pitch.
Both clubs with three hits in the ballgame. Off-speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball. Four pitches. Fast, slow, fast, slow. EK, you thinking fastball here?
It seems to fit the pattern, but you better not get too predictable out there. Guys will catch on quick.
Now a throw over to first. And he'll get dirty, but he's back in safely.
Just checking.
On there's the good curveball as he set down on strikes for the second time here tonight.
Setting up on the outside part of the plate that time, and you'll see this one again on swing track. This will register as a 12-inch break, and he just can't make contact.
Here's Marcell Ozuna as he takes a fastball off the plate for a ball 1-0. Line towards center field. In there, a base hit.
Up next for the
Marlins. And time will be called here as the pitching coach heads out to the mound and hopefully try and settle this guy down a bit. Derek Dietrich gets a shot here with two on and two out here in the fourth.
And a big two out at bat right here. You know, it's still early in this game, but you don't want to have to look back on this as a major missed opportunity later on.
And a high strike to begin the at bat. It's 0-1.
Yeah, even with two on and two away, this is not a guy that's going to back down out there. He comes right after him with a fastball and he gets ahead.
Two runs, four hits, and one error so far for the Marlins. Swing and a ball chop foul right at home plate. Nothing in two count and the pitch. Protecting on 0-2, so we'll do it again. On its way, the 0-2 pitch. That's lifted the other way out to left. Holliday's after it. And that retires the side. One for the Marlins on the solo shot. Bottom of the fourth coming up. It's now 2-0 Miami. Jed Jerko is set to lead us off in the home half of the fourth inning.
And right here is an important time for them to climb back into this one. They definitely want to even this one up sooner rather than later.
First pitch fastball off the plate there, and it's ball one. Up top, it's 2-0. Three and oh now. Seems like they're working very cautiously here. Is this a little too cautious?
Yeah, I mean, why are they giving this guy so much credit up there? He's someone that you got to come right after.
And a good comeback there. It's 3-1.
But this is the thing that's so impressive about this guy. He'll show you that good breaking ball, but then he'll run that fastball up the ladder at 92, 93.
Halfway to 100 pitches, here it is. And that misses for ball four. It's a leadoff walk that starts the bottom of the fourth.
Yeah, nothing on the scoreboard yet, so maybe this can be a start as he's on base to lead off the inning.
Striding into the box, Yadier Molina. He drew a walk his first time up. Chen sets. First pitch on its way. And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball. Hit hard to short. Fielded by Echevarria. To Gordon for one. Back to first, and they'll get the slow-footed Molina. It's a double play.
Well, if you want to go by the numbers, somewhere around 37% of leadoff walks come around a score. Now, EK, I know you didn't know that, but that won't be an issue here as he bounces right back and he gets himself the double play.
Stepping in now, Carlos Martinez. As he can't catch up on a fastball at the letters, and it's strike one.
Yeah, and that's the swing of a guy hoping for a first pitch curveball right there. If he gets it, he hammers it. If not, he's about 3 feet too late.
Two out, nobody on. Oh, and he's finding his groove out there now. It's 0-2. Swing and a miss. Blew the fastball right by him, and the inning is over. Nothing doing there for St. Louis. They're still down. It's 2-0. Adani Echevarria heads for the box to start off the fifth in this one.
Adani Echevarria.
Here comes the first pitch. Watches a fastball right there for strike one.
Well, this guy has thrown a first pitch strike to about 50% of the batters he's faced. He's pitching well, but those numbers could be pumped up a little bit.
That misses wide. One ball and one strike. Pitch swung on and hit in the air toward the line and right. And that'll get down for a base hit.
Yeah, this one looked like one of EK's four irons. He just kind of shanks this thing right down the right field line, but he manages to drop it just inside the chalk line, and that's a thing of beauty.
Standing in now, Wei-Yin Chen. And they indeed have the pitcher bunting here as he gets this one down. And they'll just tag him out along the first base line.
Well, this is a nice job here of giving himself up. You see him square and put this ball down over toward the right side of the infield, and that's just where you want it to be. They do put the tag on him, but hey, he gets the job done.
And now the Cardinals get the bullpen working here. Both a lefty and a right-hander have stood up. Here's D. Gordon now. As he takes a called strike on the black, it's 0-1.
Corner paint right there, 97 miles an hour. What are you going to do with that?
Two runs, five hits, and one error so far for the Marlins. And that's inside off the plate with the fastball. It's 1-1.
I'll give him this. He's not intimidated up there. That was inside. Close to triple digits, he didn't even flinch.
Here it comes on 1-1. Grounded back up the middle. Peralta's there. Throw gets him. Two down.
How about it? The center fielder.
Christian Yelich will stand in now. He's struck out and flied out. 0 for 2 thus far. A little tardy there. No balls and a strike. Very difficult to get on top of a pitch when it's coming in that high.
darn near impossible when it's coming at you in the high 90s. You just can't get your hands up there fast enough to stay on top.
0-2 now as a curveball drops in there for a strike. Swing and a miss, and that ends the inning. Marlins leave one as they're unable to add to their 2-0 lead. Stephen Piscotty will stand in to lead things off here, and his guys have been unable to get anything going to this point.
Yeah, and you think so many times in the postseason, we see starting pitching really come to the forefront, and this guy's been every bit as good as advertised so far.
Chen gets the sign. Here comes the first pitch. And he takes ball one. The pitch count there, one pitch into his fifth inning of work. Not much of a concern, I wouldn't imagine.
Yeah, it shouldn't be. He hasn't had any real overtaxed innings, so he should be fine for the time being.
The windup and the 1-0 pitch. And he lays off a fastball here that looked pretty good, but it's 2-0.
And that's getting bailed out at the plate.
Hitters count. Here's the 2-0 pitch. This is well struck. High and deep toward the left field corner. And that nearly would have gotten him on the board. Instead, it's a long foul ball. And this is on the inside edge, perhaps off the inside edge, but it's a called strike. 2-2 now.
Well, you get the sense that what they need is one big hit from anybody in the lineup. If they could get one, it could get them right back in this game, because right now they just seem out of it.
Swing and a miss, and he'll start the fifth the same way he ended the fourth, with a punch out, one away.
That's a nice comeback from down in the count, 2-0. He doesn't panic. He doesn't just start laying pitches in there. He had a good plan to start with, and then he executed that plan all the way through the at-bat.
Here's Randall Grichuk. As he'll go after the first pitch and send a ground ball down to third. Throw just does beat him to the bag, as that was pretty close.
The left fielder, number 7, Matt Holliday.
So bases are empty here with two gone. And here's the left fielder, Matt Holliday. And he gets ahead here with the fastball, strike one.
Well, he's thrown a first pitch strike to about 60% of the batters he's faced, so that's a pretty good percentage, because we're into the middle innings right now.
On the ground, up the middle, backhanded. And the off-balance throw gets him as he takes away a hit, and the side is retired. Down in order go the Cardinals. They trail things here 2-0. John Jason will stride in again, and you can bet he'd love to do again what he did back in the fourth. A solo home run here that's been the only long ball of the game so far. And we see a lefty and a right-hander start to loosen up in the bullpen. First pitch on its way. He slaps that one away, and the count will be nothing and one. Curveball close, but it's 1-1. And he'll try to take control of the inside part of the plate with the fastball as he backs him off a bit.
I'll say this. He wasn't going to get his arms extended on that one.
Swing and a line drive. Foul. He's ready with the 2-2 pitch. A full count, three balls and two strikes.
You don't want to lose the leadoff hitter here. Not when you got this guy on deck.
Line hard toward right center. That's in for a base hit, and he's 2-for-3.
Well, these guys have been high on effort but low on results so far. They're still stuck on two runs, but at least they've got a leadoff base runner here to start this inning.
So a runner at first now with nobody out, and set to stand in the ultra dangerous Giancarlo Stanton. Ready to deliver, here's the first pitch. Grounder hit hard down the first baseline. But a foul ball here, 0-1. Nobody out, runner on first. Lays off the circle change there, a ball and a strike.
Well, that's a pretty good spot to try and lock him up inside, but you know, he can turn on that location if that's out over the plate.
He's set. Here comes the 1-1. And he pumps the fastball by him here. 1-2 now. Heading out toward shallow right. Piscotty is under it. Makes the play. One away. Jonathan Lucroy stands into the box. He's 0-for-2 so far in this one. And that misses ball one. And a breaking ball falls in there for a strike. It's 1-1.
And you can see him trying to be a little bit more patient here. He's got two strikeouts already. But he's got to be careful not to fall too far behind.
One and one, here it is. And a breaking ball in the dirt that time for a ball. Still no fastballs in the at-bat. It's been all off speed.
That's definitely by design. He's such a good fastball hitter. You don't want to give in to his strength.
Set to deliver on 2-1. Unable to get the bat around in time, and the count evens at 2-2. Trying to strike him out for the third time. Hot shot on the ground is short. And that's through for his first base hit in this one.
Yeah, he got a little revenge there. He struck out twice before that, and now he gets him back with a solid base hit.
There goes Cardinal manager Mike Matheny on his way out to the mound. And he's going to motion for his bullpen here. That'll do it for the starter tonight. So he'll depart after 5 1/3 innings of work and with no shot to win the decision. Miguel Sokolovic will come on and try to get out of this mess here as there are two on with only one away.
Miguel Sokolovic.
Marcell Ozuna will be his first assignment here as he'll face him with runners at first and second and one gone.
That's a ball.
A fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one. 1-0. That hole getting a little deeper now. It's 2-0.
He's in a situation now where he does not want this game to get away from him. Two guys on already. Now he's not in the strike zone to this hitter. He's got to reel it back in if you're flirting with a little bit of danger now with another ball.
Here it comes, 2-0. Oh, it's hit to third. 5-4-3. It's a double play and the inning is over. Around the horn they go. 5-4-3 to end the threat. Game two coverage rolls on after this. Matt Carpenter will lead things off for the Redbirds here in their half of the sixth inning. Marlins have some action in the bullpen now as a right-hander is up and throwing. Chen into the windup. Here's the first pitch. First pitch of the inning misses here to the cleanup man. It's 1-0. Ready to deal. Here's the 1-1. Foul right at the plate. The count moves now to 1-2. Set to deal on a ball and two strikes. And that misses 2-2. Not the first time he's felt the squeeze tonight.
Yeah, he's looking and saying, what do I got to do to get a strike?
And he's getting his money's worth up there now. It's full 3-2.
And in a two-run game right here, you don't want to walk a guy leading off an inning. You got to keep that tying run in the on-deck circle as long as you can.
Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. Chopped foul right at home plate. Locked in a good battle. Here comes another one. Just staying alive, putting together a really good at bat here. A little bouncer. Lucroy scoops it up. Throws in time, and that's out number one.
The shortstop, number 27, Johnny
Peralta steps in. He was able to reach base thanks to an error in his last at-bat. First pitch coming. Here it is. A fastball off the plate away. It's ball one. This is line to left, but pretty much right at the left fielder as he takes it in for the second out.
Now batting.
That's one of the first balls they've really hit hard off him so far, and pretty fortunate that this one's right at his man for the out.
Brandon Moss will stand in now with two away, trying to avoid another 1-2-3 inning.
Now this has been total domination these past few innings. They haven't been able to mount any kind of threat whatsoever.
And a fastball close, but ultimately ruled a ball, 1-0.
Well, one thing we've seen from this guy on the mound so far, when he makes bad pitches, they typically miss out of the strike zone. They don't miss in the zone where they can be crushed.
That evens it up, 1-1. Up high, 2-1 now.
A much better approach here at the plate so far. Now he's not working from behind in the count like he has his first few at-bats.
The 2-1 on its way. Hit on the ground down the first baseline. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. 1-2-3 go the Cardinals. They're down 2-0. Welcome back to Busch Stadium here in St. Louis. It's on to the seventh now in game two, but before we start, there's a look at our game summary to this point. Derek Dietrich is set to get us started for the late innings of this one.
Derek Dietrich.
Now some action out in the bullpen as a lefty and a right-hander begin throwing. Up and away to start the inning. It's 1-0. Not close. It's 2-0. Outside, 3-0 now.
And it goes without saying, but this has to be in the strike zone. You don't want him on base to start off the inning.
He's set. Here's the 3-0. And a good take there as they'll have a leadoff man aboard to start the seventh. It's ball four.
Well, it seems to me like you've at least got to make him go after something there. I mean, the bat never left his shoulder. That's making it way too easy for a guy leading off the inning.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, Adani Echevarria. He singled his last time up. Sends that one out of play for strike one. The 0-1 delivery. Grounder down the line at third. But this will get foul for strike two. Protecting with two strikes. Went out of the zone that time, but he stays alive. A pause and the 0-2. Lifted in the air out to left. Holiday on the move. He gets there and makes the play for the first down.
The pitcher
Wei-Yin Chen comes to the plate, possibly receiving a bunt sign in order to stay out of the double play.
Yeah, and everybody's got a different opinion on this situation. But in reality, it really comes down to how the pitcher is with the bat in his hands and what he can do.
And they'll try and play for one here as he gets this one down. The tag gets one, and it's not in time as he's in well ahead of the throw.
Well, this is a nice job here of giving himself up. You see him square and put this ball down over toward the right side of the infield, and that's just where you want it to be. They do put the tag on him, but, hey, he gets the job done.
Here's D. Gordon now as the first pitch to him is off the plate for a ball 1-0. Two out here and a runner at second.
Nope.
That missed. Close. It's ball two. And he's got to be careful now that some of these borderline calls don't get him started going downhill.
Yeah, and sometimes it's really easy to dwell on those, but you have to keep looking forward. It's not easy, but you've got to do it if you want to have success.
Trying to keep the game close. Here's the pitch. Swing and a little tapper. Foul ball, however, strike one. He's fallen behind now, 3-1. Christian Yelich would be next. This is hit the other way out toward left field. Holiday moves over. No trouble with this one, and the inning is over. One left for Miami. They're up 2-0. leading off the inning, Jed Jerko, as they'll look to get something going here and even this game up.
And so far in this one, they're still getting shut out. So this leadoff at bat could be huge if he can just get on base, because they've been held in check all game.
A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. Curveball, and that misses in the dirt for ball one.
And right now, these guys just need something to break their way. A blooper, a bunt, a hit by pitch, something to get a base runner and give that guy something else to think about out there.
There's a belt high strike to even the count at 1-1. Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2. The 1-2 offering looked like a slider that time, but it's 2-2.
Oh, that's not a bad idea right there. Go ahead and try that back foot slider on a 1-2. Hope you can get him to commit. That's a good job of laying off of that pitch.
2-2 count. Here it comes. Fastball didn't miss by much, and it's a full count now, 3-2.
And down by two, you better believe they'll take a leadoff walk right here. Anything to get a base runner.
And that misses ball four. It's a leadoff walk to start the home seventh.
You know, when you're holding on to a slim lead, you just can't walk the leadoff guy. I mean, those are the ones that really come back to haunt you. So he's really going to need to work towards getting a ground ball here.
Yadier Molina will dig in now, and he'll do so representing the tying run.
Yeah, and you're not too worried about this guy jumping the yard on you here and tying the ball game. But if he does find a way to get on base, things get a whole lot more interesting.
You'll start him here with a changeup, but it's taken for ball one.
And you know, he's been the beneficiary of most of the calls here tonight, but I think that's one that he thought he should have had.
A runner at first with no outs here. Down the third baseline, but a foul ball, 1-1. Here's the 1-1. Drilled on the ground to short. Echevarria's there to Gordon for one. Back to first, and they'll get the slow-footed Molina. It's a double play.
Boy, this is a tough turn out there at short. You can see him be forced to backhand the ball and then pivot on that right leg and throw against the momentum of his body. Nothing simple about that throw, and that's an easy one to throw right out into right field.
Colton Wong will get the call to pinch hit here, as we'll see what he can do with two out and the bases empty. Ball one. And he misses again, 2-0.
Well, I'm no pitching coach, but I can see that shoulder starting to fly open a little. That ball's really taken off on it.
And he gets this fastball over. It's 2-1. A pretty dangerous spot for that one.
I don't think it was by design. It's one thing to miss your spots out of the zone, but when you miss in the zone, especially up, that's when you tend to get hurt.
Swing, and he pops him up over toward foul territory. And that will conclude matters here in the seventh. Redbirds down quietly. They trail it here 2-0. Kevin Segrist will be summoned from the bullpen now as he'll take over to start inning number 8.
Kevin Segrist.
Leading off the inning, Christian Yelich, as they'll look for some added insurance before the bottom half of the inning. On to the eighth now, as the first pitch is a fastball that's looked at for ball one.
Nope.
2-0 now.
Well, you got the matchup you wanted, but that's not going to amount to much if you can't throw strikes.
From the windup, the 2-0 pitch. Chop fouled over towards the coaching box. Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. And, oh, he's really given some leeway on the outside edge here, 2-2 now. And he is down on strikes again. So get your hats out. That's the third strikeout of the game.
How about it?
You know, it seems like every time we check these out and show motion, it always looks like the bat breaks the plane. Look here, sure enough, I don't think he holds up in time. Looked to me like that was the right call.
Here's John Jaso now, as he swings at the first pitch and lifts a pop-up out behind short. Oh, and he botches it. So chalk that one up as an E6, and he really can't believe it out there.
Giancarlo Stanton.
Giancarlo Stanton will stand in. He flew out his last time up. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Fastball too high to start him out here, 1-0. Swing and a liner. Foul. One and one, here it comes. Looked like he was on that one, but it's 1-2.
Well, he'll lean pretty heavily on that fastball. Why not? It's a big one.
Look out. That one almost got away from him. 2-2 now. Come set. Now the pitch. Got him.
I love this pitch right here. Just an elevated fastball with two strikes. Nothing much to it. He just says, this is just a good old country fastball, and he runs it right by.
In is the catcher, Jonathan Lucroy, as he'll take a look at a strike right down the middle. It's 0-1.
Not a bad idea when you're facing a guy with a funky delivery like his. You go up there taking a pitch, get yourself a better idea of the release point that he's showing you and how to time that delivery a little bit better.
Oh, and this at-bat is quickly moving from bad to worse. It's 0-2 now.
And he's really going to have to fight now. You got to take a little bit out of your swing and find a way to put this ball in play.
Can't quite get around in time to keep it fair, and it remains 0-2. And a classic 0-2 pitch as the changeup misses low, and it's 1-2 now.
Well, that's a good take there with two strikes. That wasn't an easy one to lay off of.
One and two, here it comes. Got him swinging in the dirt. The throw to first is in time, and the inning is over. Marlins leave one, but they're on top 2-0. Leading off the inning, Stephen Piscotty. And they'll need him to get something going here. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. Inside with the slider, and that'll back him up a bit.
Well, that man right there is into his eighth inning of work now. Any concerns going forward?
Well, I think the only thing you have to worry about is that pitch count you see right there. Other than that, he's earned the right to stay out there. Usually the other team will tell you when you're starting to get tired.
Swing and a liner, but foul. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Fouled off again, and now he's in a 1-2 hole. Trying to strike him out for the second time. And he struck him out. Good pitch there as he registers his eighth punch out of the ballgame.
And I'll tell you what, he's throwing with a lot of confidence right now. And he's also taking some chances with location, but you know, he's thinking he's bulletproof out there, and so far he has been.
Rendell Gritchick will stand in for the fourth time now, still looking for his first hit of the ballgame.
And he's not the only one either. This has been a great pitching performance so far, and they've had these guys chasing their tails all game long.
First pitch of the at-bat. That's yanked into the stands, strike one. The windup and the 0-1. That's taken. Now it's 0-2.
Boy, I'll tell you, to be down 0-2 against a guy like this with the stuff he's got tonight, not a comfortable spot to be in.
Hit back up the, and oh, this is off the second base bag. Gordon is up with it, and they won't get an out from this as he's able to reach on a play that you just don't see very often.
He just did everything right here on the mound. He made the good pitch. He got his guy to hit the ball on the ground. But baseball is just a little bit like life. You know, things don't always go your way. This is going to be an infield single as he reaches here with one away.
Matt Holliday gets another crack right here. He's got a hit in three tries to this point. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Ozuna is under it. And he makes the catch for the second out. Matt Carpenter will stand in now, hoping to get on track as they've been able to neutralize his power out of the cleanup spot. 0-for-3 thus far.
Well, guys, it just hasn't been his day. You know, sometimes cleanup hitters are sort of all-or-nothing type hitters. But, hey, he's still got a chance to make an impact on this game right now.
First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Now a fastball a bit too low here. It's ball one.
And even though on the mound he's had his way with him, this is a dangerous customer. So don't get to thinking you're bulletproof out there.
A runner on first with two away. A good tailing fastball for a strike, 1-1.
Yeah, he's still got that good movement on the two-seamer. He's been throwing it well all night long.
Here's the 1-1 pitch. And he'll fall behind now to 1-2. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. And he's got himself another one as he picks up strikeout number 9 here, and the side is retired. One left for the Cardinals. They trail things here 2-0. Kicking off the top of the ninth, Marcell Ozuna, as they'll look for some added insurance before the bottom half of the inning. Here it comes. Ninth inning underway now as the first pitch is taken for a called strike. They'll ride the hot hand on the mound as this man will stay out there after the 1-2-3 inning last time around.
And the more important set of numbers is that he got that 1-2-3 against the guys hitting in the middle of the lineup, 3, 4, and 5. So now as a reward, he'll get to match up with the bottom portion of the lineup here.
Inside and low, 2-1. Fastball is looked at for strike two.
Right back inside with a fastball. This time, he got the call.
Full count now, 3-2. Now a swing and he pops it foul behind the plate. One away. Derek Dietrich stands into the box. He's 0-2 so far in this one. Now here's the pitch. Outside target here and he hits it for strike one. Really a good job so far by this guy out of the bullpen.
Yeah, he's come in and really put his stamp on this game. He's thrown a lot of strikes. That's what you want.
Nope. Slider taken here. One ball, one strike. Bases are empty. One man out. Fastball. Whoa, look out. That just about got him in the coconut.
He did not like that one bit. You know, it's one thing to work in with the hard stuff, but don't do it around the dome.
A little too tall that time. 3-1 now. Pulled high in the air out to right field. Piscotty is there. Two down.
The batter number 3. Shortstop.
Adani Echevarria steps in, working on a 1-for-2 game so far. You'll start him here with a changeup, but it's taken for ball one. Two and oh. Gets the call on the changeup there, 2-1.
Yeah, you don't see 2-0 changeups too often, but if you know a good hitter is going to be sitting fastball, don't give him what he wants.
Gets the sign. Here comes the 2-1. All even now, 2-2. Bases are empty here with two men out. Swing and a liner. Foul. Ready on two balls and two strikes. Here it comes. Just out in front of that one. Still 2-2. Now a swing and a ball popped high in the air over toward foul ground. Moss has got it and the side is retired. 1-2-3 go the Marlins as they're unable to add to their 2-0 lead. Johnny Peralta will stand in to start off the night here with his guys in danger of going down two games to none if they can't rally.
Johnny Peralta!
Strike to begin the at bat. It's 0-1.
This guy has kind of walked a tightrope all game long. He's only thrown first pitch strikes to 50% of the hitters he's faced, and yet pitching a very good ball game.
A And a pitch in the dirt as he lays off. It's 1-1. Hit sharply on the ground to the left. Played on the backhand. Throw on to first, and one shortstop grounds out to the other, one away.
First baseman,
Brandon Moss, will stand in, needing to do something here to get on base as they're down to their final two outs.
Yeah, and you just can't worry about the score right here. You just got to be able to string together a couple of base runners and take it one pitch at a time, one runner at a time.
Now a ball hit hard but foul as this one forces the third base coach to dance out of danger. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. A lot of movement that time. It's 0-2.
And this is part of why he's had a lot of success so far. He's done a lot of work on the edges and stayed out of the middle of the strike zone.
One out, nobody on. Not in front of that one, but he stays alive and will do it again on 0-2. The next 0-2 misses, and that'll move it to 1-2 now. And tough fastball to lay off on 1-2, but he did, and it's 2-2 now.
Yeah, I think you have to ask yourself, was he trying to throw a fastball for a strike right there, or was he just trying to set me up for that changeup away?
And this misses, so that'll fill the count at 3-2.
And I know he wants the shutout, but with his pitch count the way it is right now, a walk right here might signal the end of the line for him.
Right side and right into the shift. Gordon on the grass, on to first, and that means the Cardinals are down to their final out now.
Second baseman,
Jed Jerko. Will stand in now as their last shot here with two away in the ninth.
Yeah, just one final hurdle here before he finishes off the shutout.
Ball too high to start him out here, 1-0. Now a swing and a ground ball. This should do it. Echevarria is there. Throw to first is going to be in time to take care of him, and the Marlins will take a 2-0 lead back home for game three as this one is over.
Well, we've talked about it all throughout this game. He was completely in charge, essentially, from pitch one. And now he finishes off a masterful performance here, getting the complete game shutout.
For one final check of the line score as you see the key players there in this shutout victory. And guys, if you're going to be successful in the postseason, as you know, you need players coming up big. And this guy certainly did that. He's our top player of the game.
And obviously, every game is so important in the postseason. But this was one they definitely needed. And he came up with a huge performance here.
So that just about does it. For EK, Psycho, and the crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. for more, get those smartphones and tablets out and head over to theshownation.com. The Marlins win it 2-0. Good night from St. Louis.